Greetings. There are a couple of really cheap Jedi mind tricks that Islam uses to deceive Muslims. When you know these techniques, it will help you see through them. The first I call the replacement diversion. The best example is the fable of the genesis of the Quran. Stated succinctly, the Quran is a product of hearsay. Mohammed heard an angel whisper or say what the angel heard from some Allah. In law, the definition of hearsay is the report of another person's words by a witness, usually disallowed as evidence in a court of law. Angel Jibril repeating what it claimed it heard Allah say, and Muhammad repeating what he claimed he heard Jibril say, are textbook examples of hearsay, which would be inadmissible in a court of law. But wait, I haven't explained the deception yet. Approach anyone from Islam and say, the Quran is hearsay, and I bet you a cup of coffee they will respond, no, we have the hadiths. Hadith means the hearsays. Therefore, the Quran cannot be hearsay. Do you understand the nature of the deception now? The Quran, which is hearsay, cannot be hearsay because Islam has a defined hearsay. Pretty clever scheme and deception if you think about it. And that is not the only usage of this technique. Let me give you the example I think is the most clever. The Bible details the end times, the last days. And the Bible details two men, two bad men, the Antichrist and the false prophet. And if you study the Bible, you will find the description of both men. The Antichrist will deny God the Father and God the Son. His followers will go out and behead Christians. If you look very close, you will know they are Muslims. The Antichrist is the Mahdi that Islam looks forward to. The false prophet will be the clown Isa of Islam, son of Maryam. And these two men will be real obvious to those with eyes to see. But Islam has also created a cover story. It is a cover story to deceive Muslims. It uses the same replacement diversion. The fable of Islam does include the Mahdi and Isa of Islam, son of Maryam. It also includes the diversion, a man called the Dajjal. And Islam claims this Dajjal character is the Antichrist. And this deception of replacement diversion works this way. If you go up to a Muslim and say, the Mahdi is the Antichrist, they will respond, no, the Mahdi cannot be the Antichrist. The Mahdi will kill the Dajjal, the Antichrist. And if the Mahdi kills the Antichrist, he cannot be the Antichrist, see? And that is another layer of icing on the cake of deception. Islam had to cover the real story of Antichrist and false prophet, but it needed reinforcing logic to support the identity shift. If you are tempted to think the Mahdi is a bad man, no, 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 the Mahdi kills the Antichrist, who is the real bad man. Therefore, Mahdi, who kills the bad Antichrist, must be a good man. Now, explaining that example, I mentioned reinforcing logic. That is another technique of manipulation and deception Muhammad employed. The best example of that is Surah 4:157, the Assad translation. And their boast, behold, we have slain the Christ Jesus, the son of Mary and apostle of Allah. However, they did not slay him, and neither did they crucify him. But it only seemed to them as if it had been so. Let's look at another translation of that, the Muntakab. And their false allegation that they slew the Messiah, Isa, the son of Miriam, the messenger of Allah, when in fact They never killed him, nor did they crucify him, but they thought they did. The Hallim translation. And said, "We have killed the Messiah, Jesus, son of Mary, the messenger of Allah." They did not kill him, nor did they crucify him, though it was made to appear like that to them. They did not kill him, nor did they crucify him. There's an implied word missing there. Even. They did not kill him, nor did they even crucify him. The first statement is a baseless conjecture. They did not kill him. The second statement is another baseless conjecture. Nor did they even crucify him. The second baseless conjecture is offered as a fence of protection for the first baseless conjecture. You see, if Jesus was not crucified, there is no way he could have been killed on a cross. And strangely enough, many in Islam now know and admit Jesus was crucified. But they redefine crucifixion to only being nailed to, not dying on, the cross. They make up and believe some fantasy of Jesus surviving a Roman crucifixion and escaping to hide as the gardener, walking, talking, eating, playing hide and seek. The crucifixion and resurrection is the central event of human history. Satan could not stop it because he was ignorant of God's plan for it. 1 Corinthians 2:8, none of the rulers of this age or world perceived and recognized and understood this. For if they had, they would never have crucified the Lord of glory. Colossians 2:15, in this way, he disarmed the spiritual rulers and authorities. He shamed them publicly by his victory over them on the cross. Revelation 1:18, I am he that liveth and was dead. And behold, I am alive forevermore, amen, and have the keys of hell and of death. When do you think Jesus got the keys to hell and the grave? That is the triumph. Jesus kicked ass, took names, and the keys to the front door of hell. The crucifixion accomplished the plan of God. Revelation 13:8. In the book of life of the Lamb, slain from the foundation of the world. And Satan could not stop it. 600 years after the shame, the defeat, Satan could only deny it. That they said in boast, "We killed Christ Jesus, the Son of Mary, the messenger of Allah." But they killed him not, nor crucified him. But so it was made to appear to them. That's the denial. Crucifixion never happened. One of the best documented events in antiquity. And a critical reason Islam exists, this unsupported denial. The third technique I'll mention is the inversion of the burden of proof. That is when Mohammed makes a baseless and unsupported question, or challenge, and claims it is true until you disprove it. Mohammed issues the challenge to find contradiction in the Quran. Surah 482. Why don't they contemplate upon the Quran? Had it been originated from anyone besides Allah, then it would have been beset with inconsistencies and contradictions. Mohammed says to produce a book like the Quran. Surah 10:38. Or do they say he has forged it? Say, then bring a chapter like this, and invite whom you can besides Allah, if you are truthful. Surah 52:33 through 34. Or do they say he has forged it? Nay, they do not believe. Then let them bring an announcement like it, if they are truthful. So Mohammed repeated himself. It seemed like a winning argument to him. But the burden of proof is on the one making the claim. Mohammed. Christians, watch for these techniques as you debate with those trained by the Quran. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.